Today's word is dhikr. Dhikr can be translated as remembrance. And it relates to a practice which the Prophet taught the Sahaba, the people around him. And they said of him, كان يذكر الله في كل أحيانه, that he would remember Allah in every moment, in every instance he was in the remembrance of the Divine. For that reason, you could almost propose the argument for calling it a kind of remembrance meditation. It has meditative qualities to it. And it's a practice of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one that remembers Allah, this is almost like a hallmark of that closeness to God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls in many times in the Quran to the merits and the greatness of dhikr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِمَ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي, establish the prayer for my remembrance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ, remember me and I'll remember you. So if a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that has nothing in comparison. It's incomparable to Allah remembering that person. And in a hadith Qudsi, أَنَا جَلِيس مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي, I'm with the one that remembers me. Now dhikr, there are many forms, there are many ways. Some of the scholars, they mentioned it was a spectrum, because Allah knew the presence of boredom within the human soul, our tendencies to become bored. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this plethora, this great spectrum of ways to approach Him and come close to Him through His remembrance. Dhikr can also mean any kind of act that you do that's devoted with intentionality for the sake of God. But specifically now we're talking about the utterance, the invocation. Now the scholars and the people of insight, they say the greatest form of dhikr is that which combines the tongue and the heart together. One time there was a person and they complained to their teacher and they said, you know, I engage in this practice, but I don't find any of these great spiritual fruits that people are talking about. You know, I'm just making dhikr on my tongue. I'm just vocalizing these utterances. And that because the person was a person of insight and he was training him, he said, praise Allah that Allah literally ornamented one of your limbs, one of your extremities with His remembrance. And the person that maintains that practice with devotion, it's like knocking on a door, that door eventually will be opened. We need to cultivate this practice. It was the practice of the people of Allah. Everything that we do through intentionality can be dhikr, but we need to, when we wake up in the morning, be people that remember Allah. When we go into the evening, be people that remember Allah. Dhikr is at the core of our tradition to bring glory to the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. May Allah allow us to be people of dhikr, to remember Him constantly and connect those invocations to our hearts to taste something of the realities of this great tradition. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.